The Jewish people are arguably history's most peace-obsessed people. One of the words that almost everyone knows, even non-Jews, is the word shalom, which means peace. By the way, it's also the word for hello in Hebrew. So basic is peace to the Jewish worldview, it's how we greet our fellow human beings. The word shalom appears 240 times in the Hebrew Bible. And the Jewish people have been pushing for millennia the notion that permanent peace is the ideal state for the human race. Yet ironically today, the Jewish state, Israel, is not in a state of peace. It is the most threatened state on the planet Earth, constantly involved in terrorism and warfare. We often hear people saying that there are governments in Israel that don't want peace. But clearly that's not the case. Modern history tells us a very different story. From the very beginning of the birth of the state of Israel, the Jewish state, comprised of the Jewish people, who are the most peace-loving people on the planet, have always been pushing the peace agenda. David Ben-Gurion, in 1948, when he declared a Jewish state, called for peace with the Arab neighbors. The Arab response was a declaration of war, Tel Aviv being bombed and five Arab armies invading. In 1967, when the Arab world tried to again destroy the Jewish state in the Six-Day War, Prime Minister Levi Eshkol immediately offered the Arab world, "We'll return all those territories, just make peace." The Arab League's response in Khartoum in August 1967, no peace with Israel, no acceptance of Israel, and no negotiation with Israel. In 2000, Ehud Barak, Prime Minister of Israel, again offered peace and it was rejected. And the Second Intifada was the response. In 2007, Ehud Olmert again offered to return all the territory that Israel won in the 1967 war. It was again rejected. And we see that historically that any country, such as Egypt or Jordan, that has come forward and been willing to accept Israel's offer of peace, has made peace with Israel. So clearly it's not about the intransigence of the Jewish state. Israel has always wanted peace, just as the Jewish people have always longed for peace. If we look at the situation in the modern Middle East in the last 70 plus years, we see that all issues of smoke screening aside, the issue seems to be much more the Arab world's inability to accept a Jewish state of any size, rather than the Jewish people's desire to block that peace process. I'm Ken Spiro, and you're watching JTV.
To stay up to date with JTV content, click subscribe here if you're on YouTube and hit the alarm bell. And if you're on Facebook, hit the like button and under following, click see first. If you enjoy watching JTV content and want to help us continue to grow, please consider making a donation to us by clicking here.